Search got a huge overhaul with iPadOS 14, and I talked about this already in my iPadOS 14 walkthrough, but it's much more like Spotlight on the Mac now. It doesn't take up the full screen, it has what's called a compact UI now. One of the major benefits of this is now when you run a shortcut from Search, it doesn't kick you over to the Shortcuts app. It runs in the Notification Center at the top of the iPad. And when I saw this during the beta process, it got me thinking on a lot of shortcuts I could build that could be really useful to run from the search bar. A lot of these I feel should be built into search, but they aren't, and that's okay because we have shortcuts. I ended up landing on 22 useful shortcuts that I've been running from search that I wanna share with you all. I'm gonna put links to all these shortcuts in the description below, but let's go ahead and go through them. First up is media controls, and being honest, this was a huge inspiration for this whole project here. I've heard from a lot of you that you want media controls on the Apple iPad keyboards, they're not there, so I kind of figured this would be a good workaround. Now, some of these shortcuts, you can easily do these actions right from Control Center. But my thought process is if you're typing away, you have your hands on the keyboard, instead of reaching up to touch the iPad screen and to go into Control Center, you could just hit Command Space and trigger these shortcuts from there. Also, you can use the Siri trigger phrase that I'm not going to say right now because it'll set this device off and also say these commands as well. So let's go through some of these shortcuts, and they're pretty self-explanatory, and I'll show you how I built a few of them. First up is play music, then pause music, play the song again, previous song, set volume, mute audio, next song, and set airplay. So you'll notice I had at least two words for every one of these shortcuts. I tried during my testing of this to set a shortcut to just be play or pause or skip. And what I was finding is search wouldn't do a good job of recognizing that was a shortcut. It was too generic of a term. It would want to give me the definition for play or pull up a whole bunch of different other things or apps. It wasn't specific enough. So what I noticed is if I had like a verb and then another word in there, that would be specific enough for its search to show the shortcut. And these shortcuts were really easy to build. Most of them were just one action shortcuts. So I would just, put in play music or pause music or play song again, whatever different action I would need. I also made a few shortcuts that are specific to Apple Music. Sorry, Spotify users. The first one will get all the recent songs that you've played. And then if you pick one, it will play its entire album. Now, there is a limitation with music actions in shortcuts. Music has to be added to your library. It doesn't have to be local on your device. It could still just be in the cloud, but you have to have it added to your library, if that makes sense. It won't just like randomly get something that you haven't added already to it. And the next one falls under the same category. It will get a random music album. I'm somebody that likes listening to albums, not playlists or individual songs or something like that. So what this does, it will go through the library and it'll look at all your songs. It'll randomly get one song, pull that song, and then play whatever album it belongs to in its entirety. But there are people out there that I know that prefer playlists. This one will get all of your playlists that you have in your Apple Music library, and you can just select from one and start playing it. Though you can easily just use search to pull up an album or a shortcut, this is kind of nice if you're not entirely sure you know what you want. This will give you a visual menu that you can go through. And of course, I have some productivity shortcuts in here as well. So first up is new task. New task, I have one for reminders and things that I will put in the description. If you use a different task manager, just swap out your task manager's actions in shortcuts for things or reminders, whichever one you download. I would recommend downloading reminders. Things does things a little differently, no pun intended right there, because Things is not a universal app. There's a separate iPhone app and an iPad app. You have to download the iPhone and the iPad app, and the actions are different from each other. So I have some logic in there to determine whether you're running it on an iPad or an iPhone. So if you're using another task manager like Todoist or OmniFocus or something like that, download the reminders one and swap out the reminders action for your task manager. But the new task shortcut is actually really handy. The way it works is it has an ask for input, and every line you make in there, so you can make multiple lines. So let's say I would put take out trash, get groceries, mow lawn. I make each of those tasks separate lines, and then when it runs the shortcut, it will split each one of those tasks up and create separate tasks for them. so you can enter multiple tasks by running the shortcut just one time. Then there's a new event one. This is both for the built-in calendar app and Fantastical. There's two versions of this one as well. You can download either one. Obviously, you'll need Fantastical if you want to use the Fantastical one. The benefit of using the Fantastical one over the calendars one is Fantastical supports natural language input. So you could just type in like basketball game at 9 p.m. on Saturday, and it would automatically fill that in. The basic calendars one, there's some more work to it. There's more steps to that to get to that point. So I personally prefer Fantastical because of that natural language input. Then there's two notes ones. New note for both Apple Notes and Drafts. Again, if you want to use a different third-party notes app, you just swap out the notes action in there, and you can use whatever notes app you want as long as it supports shortcuts. But new note basically has an ask for input. You can type in the note really quick, and then it saves it. You don't have to open your note-taking app. It makes it really simple. This is one of the shortcuts I use on the tap back feature on my iPhone. Then the next note shortcuts is new notes from clipboard. Basically, this will take what is on your clipboard and make a new note out of it. Again, this is both for Apple Notes and Drafts. And then we have some utilities. First of those is time tracking. Now, this time tracking shortcut requires both Timery, the app, and Toggle, the web service. You don't need to have the Toggle app installed. You just need to have a Toggle account. A free account is fine, but you do need the Timery app. What I like about this for time tracking, because I time track all my stuff for business and work and just making sure I'm spending time appropriately, but I do this through this shortcut right here. And basically the way it works is it automatically pulls all of my active projects from Toggle, so I can pick from that menu and then I'll start a timer for that project. And then it'll pull all my active tags, show me those, I can pick one, and then I'll assign that tag to that timer. So that way I'm keeping track of things a lot more easily. I have a lot of projects because I make each one of these videos a separate project in Toggle. So I don't want to have to manually add stuff to the widget or anything like that. So I just use this. It automatically pulls everything. So I don't have to manually add anything every time I start a new video project. Then we have Clipboard Manager. This one requires the app Data Jar. I am really impressed with this one. All you need to do is download Data Jar, open Data Jar once, and then you can run the shortcut. The shortcut will take care of building all the lists and everything you need. But what's really great about the shortcut is there's no built-in Clipboard Manager to iOS or iPadOS, which is a shame. But this is my way of getting around that. So I can run the shortcut from search or wherever, and I can take whatever's on my clipboard and add it to Data Jar, or I can get items from clipboard, and it'll show me a menu list of all the items in Data Jar under my clipboard manager there, and I can pick from whatever one I want. When I pick it, it adds it to my clipboard, and I can do whatever I want with it. Then the last utility is Set Brightness. I don't use this one as much because I think it's easier just to do it from Control Center, but it's there if you want it. Again, sometimes if you're typing away, it's just easier to hit, you know, Command Space, bring up Search, type in the shortcut name, and do your thing that way. That way you never have to take your hands off the keyboard. So it's there. But personally, I wasn't using this one as much as some of the others. Now the last group is Search. In Search. Meta, I know. Search does have basic web search, so whatever you set your default search engine to be, so on my iPad it's DuckDuckGo, but you may use Google, or there might be one or two of you that use Bing. You can just do those basic searches right there, but if you want something a little more specific, that's where these come in. So there's Maps Search, Search Amazon, Search YouTube, and Search Twitter. If you need to search one of those things a little more specifically and don't want to have to go through Google or DuckDuckGo or whatever, you can use those for this. Okay, so I know what you guys are thinking. You're like, Chris, this sounds great, but some of these are just easier to do from Control Center or other ways through the system because that's a lot of typing. Some of these are kind of long. Well, feel free to rename these shortcuts. Like if these names don't work for you, you can rename them. But also, my pal Tim Nahumek, I told him about this project and he gave me this amazing idea that it's genius. He's a genius for it. So if you go into Settings, General, Keyboard, you could do text replacements in here. So basically what we could do is set up shortcuts for the shortcut names. One of the ones I use the most is time tracking. So I set up text replacement for that. So if I hit command space and bring up search, I can type TT and then you have to hit space. I'm a little annoyed you have to hit space, but that's just the way the system text replacement works. You hit that, it fills in time tracking right there, and the time tracking shortcut will be the first one right there. You can just hit enter on the keyboard and it'll run it. So instead of me having to type out time tracking every single time, I just type TT space, there you go. I have one that's CM for clipboard manager. I have some new calendar, new drafts, whole list of things right there. And you can set them up for whichever ones you want in which any way you want. These text replacements will not come over if you download those shortcuts. You will have to set those up yourself. By the way, my pal Tim Nahumek, who gave me this idea, he is a drafts genius as well. Like, he knows more about drafts, like 10 times more about drafts than I do. He just did a big review of the latest versions of drafts that I'm gonna put in the description below. So if you like drafts, I highly recommend checking it out because there's a lot of stuff in there. I'm on the beta for drafts and there's stuff in his review that I didn't even know about and I've been on the beta the whole time. So it's definitely worth checking out. If you're interested in learning more about shortcuts, specifically how to build them, I just started a new series starting with Shortcuts 101, starting with the basics and then we're gonna work our way up to advanced stuff. I will put links to that video and that playlist in the description. Part one, or the first video of that, is out. I'm working on the second video right now, so hopefully that will be out soon. So that's it for this video. Like I said, I will put links to everything, shortcuts, apps, in the description below. Thank you all so much for watching. Like this video if you like it. Subscribe if you want to see more videos about iPads and shortcuts and all this fun stuff. And have a great day.